my daughter was sparkly. She was a very upbeat, happy girl. Little things remind me of her so much because she was so caring and so giving.
33 years have gone by since 13-year-old Robin Starr Field was brutally murdered by a classmate, 15-year-old Warren Paxton Brown, who then dumped her body in the Millstream Reservation in Strongsville. Over the years, Robin's mother has learned the terrifying details about how Paxton Brown attempted to rape her daughter in his bedroom and then beat and strangled her.
I was under the impression she only suffered for about 5 minutes. I found out she was alive in that room 45 minutes, and I couldn't help her.
Paxton Brown was tried as an adult, convicted of aggravated murder, and then sentenced to life in prison with eligibility for parole after 20 years. He has served 33 years and is now coming up for parole in December.
I'm petrified.
Robin Field's family has now organized an online petition drive asking the state of Ohio to keep Paxton Brown behind bars. He was denied parole in 2015 after a similar campaign by the family.
The family says Paxton Brown's behavior after he killed Robin provides a glimpse into a devious criminal mind. Before dumping her body here in the Rocky River, he stopped at the family home and asked how the search for the missing 13-year-old was going.
They would later learn at that very moment Robin's body was in the back seat of the station wagon that Brown was riding in that day.
No compassion for others. He's only concerned about himself. If this man is let loose on the street, there's going to be another family facing the same thing that we've been going through.
Next Tuesday, Robin Field's family will once again go before the state parole board to oppose Paxton Brown's release, and they hope to be armed with the signatures of thousands of Northeast Ohioans who agree.
And as long as I can walk and talk, I want to be there to present our side of it. She was a good kid, and she certainly didn't deserve this.
Jack Schaefer.